Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattle Lessons and welcome back to another video. Thank you all so much for tuning in. And in today's episode, we're going to be going over my top 10 favorite fragrances from the House of Zoologist, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, I originally stumbled across this company a few years ago. As a matter of fact, I was Facebook friends with Victor Wong, and he announced that he was going to launch his own brand, and I was very proud of him. And he wanted to follow this concept whereby he created fragrances, or not himself, but with the help of perfumers, he created fragrances that were inspired by different animals and their habitats. And first of all, I think that's really an interesting concept, and it's good news that the fragrances don't really smell like the animals of their namesake, but more so the habitats in which they live, or perhaps the different types of foods that they consume, or just something about it reminding us, the wearer, of that particular animal. And once I got my nose on a few of them, like rhinoceros, and it's this really heavy leather-based scent, and I tried the bamboo-heavy panda, all of them were really, really interesting. And I like that Victor Wong gives these different perfumers, whether it be Tomo Inaba, or Paul Kyler, or Joseph DeLapp, or even Celine Burrell, the opportunity to express themselves with these fragrances, I think, is incredible. And so I think Victor Wong is an amazing person. The many times that I've interacted with him, he's always been very friendly, very down to earth. And I also had the pleasure of meeting him when he came to New York from Canada, because he's originally from Canada. And he and I met at Perfumery, which is located in Manhattan. And so I'm going to leave the information down below if you are interested in checking out the store. Also, if you are interested in purchasing any of these fragrances, you may do so there or from the official website, which I will also leave a link to down below. But I have amassed a collection of pretty much all of their fragrances, with the exception of some of the ones that are marketed towards women, but I've tried those too, and I really enjoyed the way that they smell. And so I went ahead and compiled my top 10 favorites into this list, and I also made sure to remove them from the wall behind me so that you can look on the wall and see that, oh, his bottle of Moth is still there. That means it's not in the top 10 list. And so I wanted to keep all the surprises in this video. So with that being said, and because I have 10 fragrances that I need to speak about, I'm gonna go ahead and start this list right away. Because all the bottles look alike, I do need to look at them to remind myself of which one I put where in the list, but we are going to start off with the number 10. And the number 10 is a fragrance that is representative of an animal, but also an ingredient that is used quite often in the perfume industry. It should also be noted that all of these fragrances are 100% vegan, and even the ones that do contain, like beeswax, for example. So bee contains real beeswax, but no bees were harmed in the making of that perfume or in the harvesting of that ingredient. And so the number 10 fragrance is Civet. And I like that this one smells very classy, very sophisticated. There certainly is a lot of this civet note that's used in this fragrance. Of course, it is synthetic, but there's also this ambery warmth that I really think gives the fragrance oomph, but at the same time, it makes it so that it's not an overly animalic fragrance. You know, some of the ones that I didn't really care for are like Beaver. Even though I love Beaver, I think in terms of an artistic fragrance, it's so well done and I love the art behind it. And I also find it to be rather wearable, but I think that that was one of the more literal interpretations from the House of Zoologist. And so with something like this, I love how it utilizes these ingredients while also adding a nice undertone that is very agreeable. And I think that that has certainly been Victor Wong's approach as of late. And so number 10 on this list is Civet. The number 8 fragrance on this list is a fragrance that was composed by Joseph DeLapp, and he also has his own company, but this fragrance features, if I remember correctly, because I didn't actually look up the note breakdown for any of these fragrances, I do apologize if I get some of these notes wrong, but I do remember this one containing lychee, lime, and a lot of berry notes. And this one is called Dodo. So this is the extinct animal, of course, and this one is so different. There is no other Zoologist fragrance that smells like this, and there's no other fragrance out there that I've gotten my nose on, period, that smells like this. And so I like the uniqueness of the smell, I like how original it is, and it's also so easy to wear. It's a very fruity fragrance, but it also has some green undertones that I think really ground the fragrance, give it its long-lastingness, and it's a pleasure to wear. Number 9 on my list is Dodo. Number 8 on my list, I think I know what it is, and I'm just going to take a shot at it. This fragrance is discontinued, unfortunately, or I should say it's been reformulated, and a few of their fragrances have been reformulated, but this one fragrance in particular is an award-winning composition. Okay, I got it right. So this one is Bat. And this one smells like the inside of a cave. And so it has the soil tincture note, but it also has this fruity note of banana that I think makes the fragrance so unique. And I think it's the inclusion of that ingredient that also increases the agreeability of the fragrance. And so I really do enjoy that. But this one definitely gives off that cavernous vibe. I think it's a really enjoyable fragrance. It's one that unfortunately my wife doesn't really like, but you know what? That's the case with like 90% of my collection. It's just a reality that I have to come to accept, right? And so number 8 on my list is Bat. Really unique fragrance. It won an Art and Olfaction Award, and it's also one of their more unique and interpretive compositions. So let's see what the next one on this list is. And so the next one on this list is one that I put on whenever I want to feel very grounded, meditative. It's one that definitely possesses a lot of character. It's a very cool composition. I love using that word because, you know, you have some warm fragrances like camel or civet, but this one is a very cool composition. This one is called Elephant, and it has this Darjeeling tea note in there along with some florals that really clean up the fragrance. This one is very, very easy to wear, but for a zoologist fragrance, I also think it's one of the least daring fragrances that Victor Wong has put out there. If you're looking at some of the older offerings from the brand, you will notice that some of them tend to veer in very animalic territory. Luckily, this one doesn't smell like an actual elephant, but it definitely conveys that part of Asia and perhaps what some of the more exotic ingredients from that part of Asia would remind you of when it comes to a smell. And so I really do enjoy this one, and this one is Elephant. Getting into the number 6 fragrance on this list, this one I chose to include in this list because not only do I enjoy wearing it, but my wife loves this one too. And this one always reminds me of a summer vacation. And I think that's because of some of the tropical florals that are used in here. I think there's also a little bit of coconut used in this fragrance as well. And if there isn't any coconut used in here, whether it be aldehyde C18, or I think it's octalactone gamma, or one of these ingredients that give off a coconut smell, it definitely puts me in that mindset. And so it's a very tropical smelling fragrance. I love this one, and this one is Chameleon. And so if you think of that kind of a climate in which a chameleon would live, you think of some of the more warm climates out there. And so I really enjoy this one. And like I said, it reminds me of the summertime, and who doesn't like the summertime, especially when you're a teacher, right? So now we're getting into the top 5 fragrances of this list, and kicking off the top 5 is definitely the Amber Heavy Chris Carbonell composition. And this one is called Camel. So I love this one because this is a very dry, dusty, sort of an amber fragrance. You have some amber fragrances that lean on the sweet side. You know, they rely on the use of notes like vanilla and perhaps labdanum that kind of puts it in exotic oriental territory. But this one is a very dry, earthy, sort of an amber scent. Definitely different from other amber-based fragrances that I have in my collection, whether it be Amber Oud by Roja Parfum, or Alambar by Laboratorio Olfativo, or even Tom Ford's Amber Absolute. This one definitely stands out in a sea of amber perfumes, and I really enjoy this one. The next one on this list, I know what it is just because of the color of the bottle, and this one has a very distinct green color. I do like the original formulation of this fragrance, and I think it was a more of a literal interpretation of what the climate or the food of this animal would smell like, but this is the reformulated version, so it's for some a little bit easier to wear. I think it's equally artistic, and this one is Panda. This one was also made by Chris Carbonell, and I love the brightness of this fragrance. I love the bamboo note that's utilized in this fragrance, and I love the citrus notes that really give it that brightness up on top. The number 3 fragrance on this list, I do have to admit, is one of the most daring fragrances, not just on this list, but also from the House of Zoologist. And in terms of all fragrances that you will get your nose on, I do think that this is one of the most daring fragrances of all time. However, it's not that challenging to wear. And that's the funny part. I think that as long as you apply conservatively, and as long as you don't overdo it, and you're very careful where and when you wear it, I think this one can be pulled off very nicely. And it definitely gives off this gothic vibe. And so this one, it's called Tyrannosaurus Rex. And so this one was composed by Antonio Gardoni, who has a line called Bogue. And this one has a very smoky appeal to it. I forget if it's birch tar or cade oil, but it also has this rose oxide note in here, which is supposed to mimic the blood. And so this one is a very, very dark composition, definitely a gothic fragrance, and I really enjoy wearing it, especially if you want to make a statement and you want to wear something that's a bit polarizing, but you just don't really care. The number two fragrance on this list is one that I'm very proud to own. It's truly one of my favorites, and I'm not just saying it because it was released recently, because it really was, but in terms of the overall smell, I just love the smell. It's so unique, it's so different from other fragrances that I've smelled before, and the note that we're looking at in this one is honey and beeswax, and this one of course is the Pollinus Bee. So this one does contain this beeswax note in here. It's such an amazing fragrance. And when I think of other honey-based fragrances like Back to Black by Killian or Eau du Soleil by Naomi Goodsir, which is a Bertrand Duchaufour composition, if I'm remembering correctly, this one is the one that does it with the most charisma. And this is the one that does it with the most personality. I love the way that this one smells. And this is exactly how I imagined it smelling and better. And so, if you haven't tried Bee, this is the most recent release from this company. And with that being said, let's go ahead and get into the number one fragrance from my personal top 10 list of Zoologist fragrances. Now, there is a sea of fragrances out there when it comes to Zoologist. Of course, you have Macaque, you have Dragonfly, you have Hummingbird, you have Beaver, you have Rhinoceros, and I think there's something for everyone. But for my number one fragrance in this list, I chose to reserve the one that I think is just so weird, so unique, so different, in a good way, of course. I don't mean weird in a bad way. It's actually very wearable. It utilizes this almost a fantasy note that I think we don't see that often in a lot of the other fragrances. You know, when you think about some of the other fragrances, for Civet, it's definitely Civet, right? For Camel, it's the Amber. For Panda, it's the Bamboo. For Bee, it's the beeswax, the pollen, the honey. For T-Rex, it's the birch. For this one, they relied on the use of an ink accord. And you guys probably already know what it is. So this one is squid. Everything about it, from the design on the label, to the color of the liquid, to the way that it smells, the sort of musky vibe that it gives across. And I also like this pink pepper note that's used in here as well, in addition to this aquatic, oceanic, inky vibe that it gives across. It's so easy to wear. It lasts a really long time. The performance on this one is really, really good. And the overall smell is really intriguing. And it's one that is definitely, it will make heads turn. And so I really enjoy my fragrances from the House of Zoologist. There's something for everyone here. It's such a unique concept. Victor Wong is such a smart person. And I really want to thank him for his generosity, his hospitality, and also his creative direction when it comes to these fragrances. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for tuning in. This was my personal top 10 list of Zoologist fragrances. If you own or have tried any of these, I would love to know what you think. Go ahead and leave a comment down below. I also would just like to know, what is your experience been with the House of Zoologist? Leave a comment down below. I always love to read your comments. I might not reply all of the time, but I always do my best to reply to every single comment. I love you guys. If you are new to this channel and you took something of value from this video, I would love it if you could support this channel by subscribing to it. It's easy and it's free. All you need to do is click that red button in the corner, and this way, whenever I do upload future fragrance related content, it will get delivered straight to your feed. You never need to worry about missing any of my future uploads. Thanks again for watching. I love you all. We'll see you next time.